German Unity Day. The Day of German Unity is the national day of Germany, celebrated on 3rd of October as a public holiday. It commemorates the anniversary of German reunification in 1990 when the goal of a united Germany, that originated in the middle of the 19th century, was fulfilled, with the exception of Austria and the German cantons in Switzerland. Therefore, the name addresses neither the reunion nor the union, but the unity of Germany. The Day of German Unity on 3rd of October has been the German national holiday since 1990, when the reunification was formally completed. An alternative choice to commemorate the reunification could have been the day the Berlin Wall came down, November 9, 1989, which coincided with the anniversary of the proclamation of the German Republic in 1918, and the defeat of Hitler's first coup in 1923. However, 9th of November was also the anniversary of the first large-scale Nazi-led pogroms against Jews in 1938, Kristallnacht, so the day was considered inappropriate as a national holiday. See November 9th in German history, therefore, October 3, 1990, the day of the formal reunification, was chosen instead and replaced the day of German unity on 17th of June, the national holiday of the Federal Republic of Germany from 1954. Germany has historically associated various states with its nationhood and unity. Before 1871, in the area where the single state of Germany now exists, different kingdoms and principalities existed. After the unification of Germany, and the founding of the Empire 1871, there was still no common national holiday. The Sudantag was, however, celebrated every year on 2nd of September, recalling the decisive victory in the Franco-Prussian War on September 2, 1870. After the founding of the empire in 1872, there were calls for a national holiday, and there were three suggestions. No decision was made. Until 1873, the Sudantag was moved to 18th of January or the day of the Frankfurt Treaty, May 10, 1871. The Sudantag would soon also be celebrated at the universities and in many German cities. It never occurred to them to think about Empire Parade or Emperor's Birthday. Some culture ministers of the states, especially in Prussia, decided that the Sudantag would be an official festival in schools. Upon many suggestions, the date of the Emperor's proclamation on 18 January would be established as Day of Remembrance. Emperor Wilhelm I declined this. This was also the day of the first Prussian coronation of the king, which should not fall into the shadow of a united German holiday. On July 31, 1919, the Weimar Constitution would be accepted in its form by the Weimar National Congress. In memorial of this hour of birth of democracy, the 11th of August was created as Constitution Day, because the President of the Empire, Friedrich Ebert, signed the Constitution on this day. Shortly after the Nazis took power in 1933, the so-called Machtergreifung, May Day, 1st of May, was established as a national holiday in the German Reich. It was already celebrated as a day of the labor movement since 1890, and also was part of the tradition for the May dance commemorating the Walpurgis Night. Immediately after the establishment of the holiday in 1933, the Nazis banned trade unions on May 2, 1933 and occupied their buildings as offices for the Nazi movement. On March 1, 1939, Hitler declared 9th of November, the day of the failed Bierhall Putsch in 1923, as the memorial day for the movement as the national holiday. From 1954 to 1990, 17th of June was an official holiday in the Federal Republic of Germany to commemorate the uprising of 1953 in East Germany, even with the name Day of the German Unity. Since 1963, it was proclaimed by the President of the Federal Republic as National Day of Memorial of the German People. However, by the mid-1960s, as hope faded that the two Germanies would ever be reunited, this date became more of a holiday and opportunity to drink than a day to consider national unity. In the year 1990, the Day of German Unity was celebrated twice, on this date and on October 3. In East Germany, the founding day in 1949 would be celebrated on 7th of October as Day of the Republic, until the 40th anniversary in 1989. The motive for setting the date of 3rd of October as the possible Day of Unity was decided by the Volkskammer, GDR Congress, on the impending economical and political collapse of the GDR. The Helsinki Conference was set for 2nd of October, at which the foreign ministers would be informed of the results of the 2+4 talks. At the beginning of July, the governments of both German states decided on the schedule. Elections in the GDR would be held on 14th of October, and a common election for the entire country on 2nd of December. The decision on the date was finally made on 22nd of August by the GDR's minister-president, Lothar de Maizière, at a special session of the Volkskammer, which began at 9 p.m. After a heated debate, the president of the Volkskammer, Sabine Bergmann-Pohl, announced the results at 2:30 a.m. on 23rd of August. The Volkskammer decides on the accession of the GDR to the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Germany according to Article 23 of the Basic Laws effective as of October 3, 1990. In the matter near 201 there had been 363 votes. There were no invalid votes. 294 deputies had voted yes. Strong applause from CDU/DA, DSU, FDP, partly SPD and the deputies standing up in their seats, 62 deputies had voted no, and 7 people abstained. This is a historic event. Ladies and gentlemen, I believe that we have not made an easy decision, but today we have acted within our responsibilities of the voting rights of the citizens of the GDR. I thank everybody that this result was made possible by a consensus across party lines. Gregor Gysi, chairman of the said PDS, was visibly moved and made a personal statement, Madam President. The Parliament has no more and no less decided in the downfall of the German Democratic Republic as of October 3, 1990. Jubilant cheers from the CDU/DA, DSU and SPD. On November 3, 2004, the Federal Chancellor, Gerhard Schröder, suggested that the Day of the German Unity be celebrated on a Sunday, for economic reasons. Instead of 3rd of October, the national reunification should be celebrated on the first Sunday of October. This suggestion received a lot of criticism from many sides, amongst them from Federal President Horst Köhler as well as the President of the Bundestag, Wolfgang Thiers. The demand worried a part of the population because of discontent for increased working hours would be seen as a provocation and devaluing national holiday. In addition, fixing the Unity Day on the first Sunday of October would have meant that it would sometimes fall on 7th of October, which happens to have been the National Day of East Germany. This date would thus have been seen as commemorating the division of Germany rather than the reunification. The idea was dropped after a short but angry debate. The Day of German Unity is celebrated each year with a ceremonial act and a citizens' festival. The celebrations are hosted by a major city, usually the state capital, in the German state presiding over the Bundesrat in the respective year, a sequence determined by the Königstein Agreement. After Bonn in 2011, Frankfurt am Main was the second non-state capital to host the celebrations in 2015, however, both cities bear a significance for German history. Bonn is former capital of West Germany and Frankfurt Parliament of 1848-49. In addition, various celebrations are held in the federal capital Berlin, mainly based on the Strasse des 17 Juni and around the Brandenburg Gate. State capitals and also other cities often have additional festivities. Furthermore, the Oktoberfest beer festival in Munich, which traditionally runs until the first Sunday in October, now runs until 3 October, if the Sunday in question falls on the first or second day of October. The celebrations in the host city always includes a festival and fireworks show. At the 1999 Day of German Unity celebration in Wiesbaden, the Compass Confederation was formalized. The Zipfelbund are the four communities at the cardinal compass points of Germany, north, List on the island of Zuild, west, Selfkant, south, Oberstdorf and east, Görlitz. Together, they always participate in the respective annual celebration to represent the modern borders of Germany. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.